Back. This is part 4 of pile foundation series. In this video tutorial, we are going to solve a numerical on pile load capacity using analytical method. In the part 3 of this video series, we have seen analytical solution of pile foundation, and in this video tutorial we are going to use that method that we have seen in part 3 and we'll solve a numerical. So if you have not seen part 3 of this video series, I'll strongly recommend you go and check out that video first, then you will be able to understand what is going on in this video. Okay, so I'll give you the link somewhere on the top. Please watch that video first. If you already seen that video, then it's okay. Let's go ahead. So what we have over here is a concrete pile 40 centimeter diameter was driven into the sand of loose to medium density. This is an important thing, that the given soil is sand having density loose to medium, and embedded depth of the pile is 12 meter, and there are some bunch of other properties are given, that is gamma is given, phi value is given, angle of internal friction is given, that is okay, average KS is given, that is 1, and angle of friction between pile and soil is given, delta, that is 0.7 times of phi. So next, what we need to calculate is ultimate bearing capacity of pile. Once we calculate that, by using that we have to calculate allowable bearing capacity. Okay, and there are some assumptions that we have to make. First assumption is that water table is at great depth. That means the water table is not going to affect our gamma value. And other, we have to use Berezanskiy's method. This method we have seen in previous part. We'll apply this method in this video. Okay, so let's start. So first of all, let's write down what is the given data. Given data is this pile is given, and the pile has embedded depth of 12 meters. Then we have diameter is given, 0.4 meter. Gamma is given, phi is given, KS is given, delta is given, factor of safety is given, 2. And now next we'll see how to solve this numerical. Okay, so before solving any numerical, the best practice is to decide what will be your solution strategy. Okay, here I have kept it very simple. So you already know the formula for QU is QPU, that is end bearing pressure multiplied by bearing area plus FS multiplied by surface area. Okay, so in step 1, we'll calculate all areas that are required, that is the value of AB and AS we'll calculate. In step 2, we'll calculate the value of QPU. So we'll calculate this value QPU into the step 2. And in step 3, this is the formula for QPU. We'll see later on in detail. And in step 3, we'll calculate the value of FS. Okay, so once we do that, once we calculate the value of FS, we'll have all the values necessary for calculation of QU. Okay, so that will be the formula for FS that we'll be using. So first step, calculation of area. So first area, so given properties are, length is given 12 meter, D is given 0.4, AB is a point bearing area. As it is circular pile, the area will be pi by 4 into D square, D is given. So once you calculate that, you will get the value of AB as 0.125 meter square. AS is nothing but the surface area of the cylinder. So the formula is 2 pi RL, where R is a radius of the pile, that is T by 2. We have D is 0.4, so that value will become, R will become 0.4 by 2. Once you put that value into the equation, you will get area as 15.08 meter square. So we have completed our step 1. In step 2, we'll calculate the value of QPU. So in part 3, we have seen this is the formula for QPU. But as the given soil is a sandy soil, therefore C equals to 0. That means your value of QP in this equation, once you put the C equals to 0, you will get QP equals to sigma prime into NQ. Okay, so next we'll calculate the value of NQ. Once we calculate the value of NQ, we'll calculate the value of sigma prime. So let's focus on NQ first. So we have to use Berezanskiy's method. What does this method gives? This method gives us this chart. By using this chart, you can calculate the value of NQ. So what are the factors that are required? First thing, we need the value of angle of internal friction, that is phi. Phi is given to us, 35, no need to worry about it. Next, we need L by D ratio. So for our soil, so for our numerical, L is given 12, D is given 0.4. So your L by D ratio is 30 and your phi is 35. So let's go to this 35 and L by D, this 30 will be somewhere over here. So from this, you can calculate the value of NQ will be just a little bit below 50. So that value I have taken as 48. So NQ will be 48. This is how we'll use Bersancieux's method to calculate the value of NQ. There is a one more method given by the Meerhof. You can also use that method, but the numerical is specifically mentioned to use this method. So we have used Bersancieux's method. Okay, so in the value of QPU, if you have calculated the value of NQ, our next task will be calculate the value of sigma prime. So sigma prime equals to gamma into LC. This is again we have seen in our previous video. Now this LC gamma, gamma is given to us 18 kN per meter cube. We will not have to worry about it. But the value of LC we have to calculate. This LC is nothing but critical depth of the critical length of the pile. So as we have seen earlier, critical length of the pile for loose to medium sand is 15 times of D. So we have value of D, LC equals to 15 times of D. Our D is 0.4, L is, so your LC becomes 15 into 0.4, that is 6 meter. So you have got the value of LC over here. So you can easily calculate sigma prime. Sigma prime is equals to this gamma, that is 18 multiplied by 6. You'll get the value of sigma prime as a 108 kN per meter square. As it is stress, its unit will be kilonewton per meter square. Next, so for to calculate the value of QPU, we have both NQ we have calculated using Bersancieux's method, sigma prime we have just calculated. So your value of QP equals to 5184 kilonewton per meter square. So this is how we'll reach to our step number 2. Okay, so till this step, what we have calculated, we have calculated QPU, we have calculated AB, we have calculated AS. The only thing remaining is calculation of FS. That is our step number 3. Actually, this should be step number 3, not 2. Please correct it. So the formula for FS is very simple. K into sigma average multiplied by tan delta. So as you can see over here in this, we have also seen this in previous part. There are, because of this critical length LC, we have two parts of stress variation. The part one is from 0.0 to LC. Your stress increases in a downward direction, but it only increases up to the value of LC, and after that your stress remains constant. Okay, so basically you have two different type of stress distribution. So your FS will be addition of F in this area for this diagram and F in this area. Okay, so we'll calculate, we'll add stress variation in both of these areas and we'll get the value of FS. So first, to calculate the value of FS, we need sigma AV. To calculate the value of sigma AV, we need the value of sigma at this level. At this level, the value of sigma will be very simple. Gamma into LC. Gamma into LC, we already seen that value comes as a 108 kN per meter square. So at this level, let me rub it out. This is a very important step. If you don't understand anything, please comment onto the video. I'll explain you one more time. Okay, so at this level, you have got sigma as a 108, and after that, that sigma 108 is constant till the bottom. Okay, so that's why at the bottom again you will get the value of sigma as a 108. Now, how do we calculate the value of sigma AV1? What is this sigma AV? Because this F1 will be equals to K sigma AV1 into tan delta. This sigma AV1 is related with this triangle. So, this sigma AV1 equals to average. This AV stands for average for diagram number 1, that is triangle. So, how do we take the average? Average will be equals to 0 plus 108. So, 0 at this point at the top, 108 at the bottom. Okay, so 0 plus 108 divided by 2 will give you 54 kilonewton per meter square. That is sigma average for this figure, triangular one. Okay, similarly, sigma AV2 is related with this figure. Now, in this figure, there is no zero value. At the top, it is 108. At the bottom, again, it is 108. So, average will be equals to 108 plus 108. Divided by 2, that is 108 kilonewton per meter square. So, in order to calculate the value of F1, you need sigma AV1 and sigma AV2, which we have just calculated. So, what we'll do, we'll calculate the F1, then we'll calculate the value of F2, then we'll add F1 plus F2, we'll get the value of Fs. So, F1 equals to, the formula is here, K is given 1. Sigma AV1, 54 we have just calculated. Tan delta, delta is nothing but 0.7 times of phi. Phi is 35, which we have put over here. So, your value of F1 equals to 24.60 kilonewton per meter square. Similarly, we'll calculate the F2. This is your K, this is your sigma AV2, and this is your tan delta. So, your F2 equals to 49.21 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so the only thing remaining is calculation of Fs, that is F1 plus F2. Just add these values to this value we have calculated over here. F2 we have calculated over here. Add these two values, you will get the value of Fs as 73.81 kilonewton per meter square. So, for our final formula Qu, what we needed all these values which we have just calculated over here. I have given it for your reference. You should check all the calculations. Okay, so once you put these values into this equation, you will get this equation. Just solve it, just calculate it. You will get the value of Qu as 2132.32 kilonewton. That is nothing but your ultimate load carrying capacity. That is ultimate pile load. This is the first thing that we have been asked to calculate. Second thing, we have been asked to calculate the value of Qsafe. Qsafe is nothing but this Qu divided by factor of safety. Factor of safety is given 2. So, once you divide this value by 2, you will get the value of Qsafe as a 1066 kilonewton. Okay, so this is how we solve the numerical on pile load test by using analytical method and Bergen-Sau's method. So, for your reference, I have given this numerical in the PDF form into the description. Please go and solve that numerical. If you find any mistake, please let me know into the comment. In next part, we'll see how to determine the bearing capacity of pile when the pile is in cohesive soil. We'll see the theory as well as numerical into the next part. As usual, thanks for watching. You guys take care.